Let us pray.
O God, who has established knowledge for our discernment and wisdom for our increase, be with Darlington School today as we celebrate the graduation of the class of 2023. We give thanks for those who have nurtured us, taught us, and given us both discipline and encouragement. May the members of this graduating class grow in knowledge and wisdom from this day forward. Be present in our rejoicing, we pray. Amen.
Please be seated. It is my great pleasure to welcome you to this celebration and graduation exercises for the class of 2023. It is great to see you all today on this beautiful day by the lakeside at Darlington School. We want to offer a welcome and a thank you to the members of our Board of Trustees who join us here today. And thank you especially to Scott Dozier, class of 1973, chair of the board, who joins us on stage to participate in today's ceremony. We want to say welcome and thank you to our faculty and staff. Without them, none of us are able to be here today to celebrate this wonderful class. Faculty and staff, thank you for all you do. And we welcome especially the honored members of the class of 2023, their families and special guests. You've made it to graduation. Congratulations. I think at this time it's also important to take a moment to remember those that have supported us on this journey, but who cannot be with us today. If you will join me in a moment of silence as we honor them. Thank you. At this time, I would like to ask anyone who is an alum or alumna of Thornwood or Darlington Schools to please stand and be recognized. If you are a senior affectionately known as a Dar baby, will you please stand? And if you made it as a four-year boarding student at Darlington, will you please stand? And now I would like all parents of the members of the class of 2023 to please stand so we can give you all a big round of applause. Today is the 118th commencement exercises of Darlington School. Commencement is a special word as it is defined as both a beginning and as an end. We will grant diplomas at the end of the academic year as you go off on new and exciting adventures. Class of 2023, we know that you are ready for the next chapter. You faced adversity and navigated a high school experience unknown to any of us. Take a deep breath or several and enjoy these moments today. It is not overstating the case to say that you are one of the most significant classes in the history of the school. I mean, when you were in the ninth grade, we literally told you not to come back. Fortunately for us and for Darlington, you did. And more joined you. And you have truly left your mark on this school, and we are grateful. As your career as a Darlington student ends, I hope that you know that we love you and that you will always be a Darlington Tiger. Take what you've learned, your successes, your failures, your relationships, your individuality, and be confident in knowing that you make a worthy contribution to our world. As you continue to write your story, my hope for each of you is that you will choose to live a life of wisdom by thinking deeply and reacting slowly. Service by always doing more that is expected of you, and honor by telling the truth both to yourself and to others. At this time, it is my pleasure to introduce the president of the student body, a member of the class of 2023, to come forward and share his thoughts as a representative for the class. During his tenure as president of the student body, Colin Rego has thought big, dreamt big, and acted big. From fireworks at prom to celebrate his class, to a highly successful senior service day and fundraiser for the Bagwell Food Pantry and Backpack Buddies, for his steady leadership on Monday assemblies day in and day out. He's got big ideas and a bigger heart. Please join me in welcoming Colin Rego.
All right. I'm no McConaughey, but I'm going to do my best for you guys today. I'd like to start out by thanking our parents who have helped us through the highs and lows so that we can be here today to enjoy this momentous occasion. I would also like to acknowledge the administrators, the faculty, and staff for all you do each and every day to make Darlington such a great place to be and to learn. And a special thanks to Mr. Bell, Mr. Woods, and Miss Lucas for listening to and supporting, well, mostly supporting, my crazy and ambitious ideas this past year. Although I still think getting Tom Cruise to do a flyby today in a plane would have been pretty cool, but I digress. High school, and especially senior year, starts off with so many opportunities and the thrill of what might be, of what might be. For some of you, that opportunity might be investing in dorm life in hopes of becoming a prefect and leading your house to victory, excelling in sports in hopes of playing at the next level one day, perfecting an instrument or talent in hopes of performing to huge and sold-out crowds, focusing on academics in hopes of getting into your dream school, and I can go on and on. Regardless of the opportunities, regardless of the aspirations, life is sometimes going to get in the way. Sometimes life is going to have a different plan for us. It may be just an interruption, or it might be a real obstacle. And when you've invested so much of your time and so much of yourself into your opportunity, and it's not working, you might start thinking, well, why me? What did I do to deserve this? What am I doing wrong? You might even feel like giving up. Since life isn't always going to be the way we planned or intended for it to be, I want to encourage you to make your focus about the journey, about making meaningful memories, and not solely striving for that glorious endpoint. It's easy to get caught up in the pursuit of dreams, the process, and then the uncertainty when those dreams don't work out. Rather, we have to be purposeful and intentional to live in the moment and make the most of it, because before you know it, it's time for those bagpipes to play. Time to descend the steps from the hill where so many Darlington alumni have preceded us. Time to walk across this stage to accept our diploma and then head off to college, to the workforce, wherever our path may be leading. I think a quote that sums us pretty well is that we are in process. The approach is the destination. And don't get me wrong, I'm not saying that we shouldn't pursue our dreams. Just don't spend so much time and energy focused on the pursuit that we don't enjoy the ride. And you don't make the important memories along the way. There's a Latin saying, which some of you may know, "Memento mori." This roughly translates to, "Remember, you must die. You must die." It may sound pretty dark for such a wonderful day, but it's often in darkness where light shines the brightest. The modern take on the phrase is that life is short, and by the time we all learn to appreciate that fact, it's often too late. Let us not be too late in our realization of this. Rather, let's focus on making our collection of special memories and moments. Matthew McConaughey says, "Stop thinking about what's ahead, what's around the curve. Don't be in a rush to get anywhere. Be present and embrace everything that is right now and give these memories the justice they deserve." I'm often asked, what do I want to do to make a name for myself? While I'll aspire to be the next business mogul and 007 in my free time, what I can do and what I can control and what I can definitely achieve is being a memory maker. And you know me, I like a good challenge. So today I'm gonna challenge you guys to become a memory maker too. Because regardless of whether we reach that point we're aiming for, and no matter what that point translates into, we are always gonna have the meaningful memories to keep and treasure. Commit to act on this challenge, because the memories will help fuel the fire of joy and fulfillment in life. I can guarantee that. About a year ago, I declared another challenge to my fellow classmates, my mantra, if you will. I hope you all took that challenge to heart and made some leaps and bounds in your lives. I know Ms. Haynes has, and that you continue to do so. And if you haven't, it's not too late to start. For those of you who are unfamiliar with my mantra, it's from a little movie called Risky Business, and it goes something like this. You know, there's one thing I've learned in all my years. Sometimes you gotta say, what the heck? Saying what the heck gives you freedom. Freedom brings opportunity. And opportunity makes your future. So, Darlington class of 2023, as you head out to define your future and say, what the heck, don't forget to take the time to enjoy and make memories. And as always, remember the name Rego. Thank you, guys.
Thank you, Colin. It is now my pleasure to ask three students to come forward and introduce today's commencement speaker. I'd like to ask Kate Scott, Parker Scott, and Rylan Scott to come forward at this time to introduce our speaker.
Good morning. My name is Rylan Scott.
I am Parker Scott.
And I'm Kate Scott.
We are pleased to introduce the commencement speaker for the class of 2023, our father, Dr. Rylan Scott. For the last 19 years, I've been blessed to get to share his name, which is truly an honor because of his reputation as not only an excellent surgeon, but also a philanthropist and community leader, which has provided me such a great standard to strive for through my time at Darlington.
I don't share his name. But I do share his incredible sense of humor. But most importantly, what I have learned from my dad is his caring and tender spirit. Whether it's caring for my friends, his patients, or foster children that come through our home, my dad has taught me to honor each person before me.
As of this fall, my dad and I will share an undergraduate education at Washington and Lee University. His life has modeled to me a strong work ethic and passion for learning. While some may call his various hobbies a midlife crisis, as he bought a tractor, became a pilot, and joined the SWAT team, I see it as evidence of his love for life and sense of adventure.
After 19 years of listening to his pearls of wisdom, now it's your turn.
It's our honor to introduce Dr. Rylan Scott.
introduction. They're going to have me crying before I ever get started. But thank you, Mr. Bell, faculty, staff, board of directors, the class of 2023, and friends and family, for the privilege, truly, the privilege of addressing our Darlington class of 2023. I come to you today in one of my favorite roles as the proud father of three soon-to-be Darlington graduates. Also, a proponent of the Darlington culture that has truly shaped their lives. We are here to celebrate all that's been accomplished by these graduates and a heartfelt charge to keep going. So, there's much to say today, as you are all individuals with different backgrounds heading into varied futures, but a few things hold true for all of you all the time. The first, and one of the most important, is the importance of gratitude. Walking through this senior season, it's been the word I've come back to time and time again. I am truly grateful for the opportunity my family's had here in the Darlington community. First, to the faculty and staff, thank you. On behalf of all the parents, thank you. Thank you for making our treasures your treasures. Thank you for seeing in them things that we could not. Thank you for creating spaces for them to learn and to grow. Thank you for persisting with courage and with creativity as we face COVID and all the challenges it brought with us. For celebrating their successes and, more importantly, for teaching them through their failures. Thank you. We are all very grateful for your help. Second, family and friends, you have been a part of this village around these young adults, so thank you. Thank you. In addition to the lessons these graduates have learned and experienced in the classroom, in the dorms, and the extracurriculars, they have been many they have learned either in your bedroom, or sorry, not in your bedroom, that'd be a little odd. In your living room, maybe. So, in your living room, in your car, carpooling around, as well as few words of encouragement as they leave the soccer fields, the stage, or another competition. Hopefully not your bedroom. So thank you. Thank you for being here. And I don't just mean here today, but thank you for being here, for being your consistent presence in the lives of the member of the class of 2023. For your fingerprints are all over their lives. I hope you're able to bask in the celebration today, because we truly would not be here without you. Finally, to the graduates. I hope you can pause for a moment and look around at your classmates. Seriously, take a moment. Just look around. Consider the gifts you have been to one another all these years. This class is remarkable. You bring so many different experiences and passions and accomplishments to the table. Rather than seeing that as a challenge, you have leaned into the opportunity. Over the years, you have done your personal best, and you have inspired others around you to do the same. This is evident by your accomplishments in your academics, your athletics, and your other accomplishments. It's notable even today that right now as we speak, some of your classmates are away competing at state finals, and others have already brought home the gold. It is said, a rising tide lifts all boats. In observing this class, that seems to be the defining feature. When I talk to someone that knows you, the conversation becomes about how strong and well-rounded this class has always been. You've excelled in many different aspects of your lives. Excellence begets excellence. And you have all had a profound impact on one another, challenging one another to continue pushing forward. As I've cheered you on from the stands at events through the years, I've always been struck by the way you cheer each other on as well. You are who you are today because of your classmates' presence in your lives. In many ways, you have been a part of raising each other. I believe that as you move on from this place, your gratitude for the shared experience will only deepen. You will smile as you remember the lessons learned beyond the classrooms. You practice perseverance in the band room and the athletic fields. And you learn strategy as day students trying to get away with parking at Trapeer. You faced your fears during rumpus challenges like gauntlet and lip sync. And you refined your coordination playing ultimate ping pong in the ground. You developed understanding of culture and diversity from living and learning in international class. And you found peace around the lake behind us, likely only to have it disrupted by feisty swans or blaring train. You explored passions by helping others through service projects. and you learned how to be a friend in the lunchroom, in the hallways, in the dorms. And you were reminded of the importance of laughter and play during the junior-senior prom. And all of this, all these memories, all of this brings us to today. Today, the reason we are here this morning is to mark a life transition. At the conclusion of the ceremony, your title will change from student to alumni. You're at the crossroads of where you have been and where you're headed. And for most of your life, your identity hasn't involved much of choice of your own. You were in a family that helped make your choices, including the decision to attend Darlington. Your experiences so far have formed your roots, but the branches, they're up to you. In order for a tree to thrive, the branches must adapt. They must grow and extend and move away from the roots. As they extend and adapt, twisting and turning, they reach for the light. I hope you will do the same. You've had countless opportunities in the school community to try new things within the confines of the safe place. Now it's time to be road tested. Each of your goals are different, but you're progressing towards them in your own way. As you pack your cars, both literally and figuratively, what will you take with you? I would recommend three key elements to a successful next level of your journey. Good directions, good company, and good fuel to propel you forward. First, good directions. A good road trip's only as good as your GPS, because direction, not intention, determines destination. If you want to go to the beach and you head north out of Rome on 75, you are unlikely to find your toes in the sand. All right? So to achieve your goals, you must apply discipline and consistency every day. You don't have to have it all planned out. Certainly not. Colin just shared that with us. You don't have to have it planned out. But you simply have to ask yourself, who do you want to be when you're introduced 10 or 35 years from now? And make decisions today that that person would make. Again, direction, not intention, determines destination. Second, good company. Who's going on this journey with you? Who are you going to put in your car? Because remember, community matters. This community has mattered for you. So who you surround yourself with matters, because excellence begets excellence. And the community you have here has created a strong foundation of roots. Look for that in the next place. And if you can't find it, well, then create it. Connect people heading your direction with similar end goals in mind. As the saying goes, show me your friends and I'll show you your future. But remember to be community to each other as well. As a contributor, not just a consumer, you weren't given gifts to be greedy with them. You've been entrusted with talents to share with the world. So keep refining your crafts and then serve your neighbors. There is hardly a reward greater than contributing to your community. And finally, good fuel. The values you've learned in this community will be the fuel that propels you forward. Wisdom more than knowledge, service beyond self, and honor above everything. The school is building character as much as it's about learning content. Focus on who you are, work ethic, grittiness, commitment, discipline. These are the things in life that are important, and your life will flow from there. Again, I urge you to connect with people and organizations that contribute, that continue to be good sources of fuel. Your output will only be as good as your input. So now, as your final charge, as we complete our time together, I encourage you, the Darlington class of 2023, to be grateful for this community and the lessons learned while here at Darlington. But remember, the greatest proof of your gratitude will be what you do with what you have been entrusted. So in order to use your gifts to their fullest potential, pack up your proverbial car with good directions, good company, and good fuel. But ultimately, I want you to remember that you're not defined by what you do either. You're defined by who you are. So my final reminder is this: you are loved. You don't need to look around this place and be reminded of the great cloud of witnesses that's cheering you on. This is your home team, and we will keep cheering for years to come. Proud of you guys.
Thank you, Dr. Scott. It is now my pleasure to present the outstanding Darlington Strings Ensemble and Concert Choir under the direction of Mrs. Annie Camp, Ms. Alex Johnson, accompanied by Mrs. Kim Tennell.
what you sow, you will reap. Reap what you sow. What you plant in your life will surely grow. And what you grow with love will surely bloom. And the fruit of your labor will come back to you. Come back to you. Do not tire from doing good. And never give up when the road gets a rough. For one day soon a great reward you'll see from the good you've done when the harvest comes. When the harvest comes, what you sow, you will reap. What you sow, what you plant, your life will surely keep until you achieve the things you strive and taste the joy, and then you'll taste the joy of your reward. Come taste the joy of your reward.
Thank you, orchestra, concert choir, Annie, Kim, and Alex. Before I announce the salutatorian and valedictorian of the class of 2023, we need to recognize three other groups of students who have achieved distinction this year. You will notice in your programs that some students are identified as graduating with honors, high honors, and cum laude. Acquiring these distinctions is no small feat. Honors graduates have a final senior average of 90 or above with no final grade below 85. High honors graduates have earned a final senior average of 95 or above with no final grade below 90. Finally, the cum laude is the secondary school equivalent of Phi Beta Kappa and is the highest academic honor Darlington can bestow on a student. Membership is based on superior academic performance in 9th through 12th grades with a minimum cumulative average of 93 or higher and at least 2 honors or advanced placement courses each year or 8 such classes over 4 years. High class rank, sound character, and a satisfactory personal record. Please join me in recognizing these three groups of graduates for their commitment and achievement. Now I will present the medal to the salutatorian of the class of 2023, Connor Boughton Brown. The medal for the valedictorian of the class of 2023 is awarded to Addison Eliza Payne.
We had the pleasure yesterday of honoring many students at Honors Day. The two highest awards given at Darlington in any academic year, however, are presented at graduation. They are the Thornwood Bracelet for General Excellence and the Darlington Medal for General Excellence. These honors are bestowed upon a senior girl and a senior boy who have made valuable contributions in many areas of school life, and whose lives exemplify the characteristics of integrity, responsibility, service, and scholarship. The 2023 winner of the Thornwood Bracelet for General Excellence is Catherine Gilstrap Scott. The 2023 winner of the Darlington Medal for General Excellence is John Alfred Cowan III.
Class of 2023, in just a few minutes, you will become alums of this great institution. As a faculty and staff, we're proud of all that you have accomplished. We know that you will leave here with confidence, connections, and compassion to be successful in both your college and career and be meaningful contributors to the greater good. Soon to be graduates, you hail from 12 countries and 13 states. 22 of you have spent your entire academic career with us, the Dar Babies. 18 of you are four-year boarding students. 14 of the 18 are international residents. 14 of you have parents who are alumni. 4 of you have grandparents who are alumni. And one of you is a fifth generation legacy. 55 of you have relatives who have graduated from Darlington. You are athletes, artists, and servant leaders. You have 5 sets of multiples, 4 twins and triplets. You've been accepted at 214 different colleges. You have earned over $8.6 million in scholarships, not including the Hope Scholarship. You will be attending 75 different colleges throughout the U.S., Canada, Israel, and Hong Kong. You all will forever be a Darlington Tiger. Mr. Dozier and Mr. Bell, on behalf of the faculty, I am proud to present to you the exceptional graduates of the class of 2023. We will now award their diplomas. Seniors in the first row, please stand and come to the base of the stage and wait as I read your names.
Ha ha ha. try again. Emma Elizabeth Adams, Greenville, South Carolina. Ayo Mikun, Timmy Dio, Adam Rayleigh, Victoria Island, Nigeria. Olawashigun, Olawashu Bonnie, Ojibwe, Atlanta, Georgia. Indiana, Obase, Oge Chuku, Akpan, Lekki, Lagos, Nigeria. Eliana Catherine Allen, Rome, Georgia. Alden Elizabeth Baker, Augusta, Georgia. Braden James Bell, Rome, Georgia. Thomas Hallman Bethel, Atlanta, Georgia. Kian Tay Bazil, Johannesburg, South Africa. Maria Isabel Boswell, Rome, Georgia. Heidi Danielle Botwinick, Dunwoody, Georgia. Sarah Rose Botwinick, Dunwoody, Georgia. Emily Elizabeth Claire Boykin, Atlanta, Georgia. Leah Faye Brazington, Armarchie, Georgia. Caroline Cecilia Brewster, Rome, Georgia. Belle Anna Brooks, Rome, Georgia. Connor Boughton Brown, Rome, Georgia. Feng Yu Xiao, Shanghai, China. Kenneth Grant Carpenter, Rome, Georgia. Kai Jun Chung, Hong Kong, Hong Kong. Rylan Slade Clevenger, Rome, Georgia. Elizabeth Allen Cordell, Rome, Georgia. John Alfred Cowan III, Rome, Georgia. Jacob Andrew Day, Rome, Georgia. Georgiana Ray Dempsey, Rome, Georgia. Daniel Richard Donatio, Rome, Georgia. Emmanuel Neil Duran, Georgetown, Grand Cayman, Cayman Islands. Logan Mark Floyd, Adairsville, Georgia. Cameron Evan Jace Fountain, Rome, Georgia. Grayson Evans Fricks, Rome, Georgia. Samuel Albee Fricks, Rome, Georgia. Ricardo Frode de Golfing, Germany. Gus Robert Gamage, Cedartown, Georgia. Amelia Beatrice Gardner, Nassau, Bahamas. Ryan McLeod Glass, Rome, Georgia. Jack Elliott Good, Rome, Georgia. Christopher William Hagler, Rome, Georgia. Yu Shin Han, Beijing, China. Gatlin Scott Hancock, Rome, Georgia. Ava Gabrielle Herring, Kingston, Georgia. Daniel Hotai, Kingston, Jamaica. Leah George Hauser, Rome, Georgia. Shami DiCarla Hudson, Rome, Georgia. Davis Kirkland Inman, Rome, Georgia. Wesley Jennings Inman, Rome, Georgia. Latija Shemay Jackson, Rome, Georgia. Josiah Zundane Johnson, Georgetown, Grand Cayman, Cayman Islands. Jacaria Jayla Alexis Johnson, Rome, Georgia. Ravenna Pia Hohola, Jackson, Tennessee. Daria Kara Mushkina, St. Petersburg, Russian Federation. Magdalawi Simacho Kabade, Abbas, Abu Dhabi. Joseph Andy Kite, Rome, Georgia. Allison Francis King, Rome, Georgia. Noah Andrew Kenny, Rome, Georgia. Jaden Chadley Lance, Rome, Georgia. Philip Henry Latafe, Rome, Georgia. Olivia Whitney Loffridge, Rome, Georgia. Brian Lee, Seoul, Republic of Korea. Hattie James Lester, Cartersville, Georgia. Anji Lee, Hangzhou, China, Inazimsha. Zhe Xian Lo, Taipei City, Taiwan. Rocco Fabian Lopez, Kingston, Jamaica. Lauren Mika Lynn, Hubert, North Carolina. J. Jennifer Maria Martinez, Brooklyn, New York. Jonna Alice Massey, Cave Spring, Georgia. Claire Marie Mathern, Anchorage, Alaska. Lillianne Blair McLean, Rome, Georgia. Quindarius Tyree McClarity, Rockmart, Georgia. Leah Shea McEnany, Eagle River, Alaska. Haley Ann Metrick, Townsend, Maryland. Rhea Mongia, Marietta, Georgia. Noah Christopher Morris, Nassau, Bahamas. Prince Emmanuel Mugisha, Kampala, Uganda. Gianna Grace Monroe, Nassau, Bahamas. Jordan Favor Monroe, Nassau, Bahamas. Thomas Jacobs Norris, Cartersville, Georgia. Liam Locke Norton, Rome, Georgia. Adora Ayo Mipe, Nuwani, Atlanta, Georgia. Brock Aiden O'Hearn, Alexandria, Virginia. Chuku Ebeka Brian Obioha, Lagos, Nigeria. Olamide Jose Maria Oluwaran, Bonny Island, River State, Nigeria. Bowden Case Owens, Cave Spring, Georgia. Simon Paluk, Roslov, Poland. Annika Shanti Patel, Rome, Georgia. Fina Nilish Patel, Rome, Georgia. Shayali Tushar Patel, Rome, Georgia. Viraj Virol Patel, Rome, Georgia. Addison Eliza Payne, Ackworth, Georgia. Bryant Lyndon Powell, Silver Creek, Georgia. John Clarence Quant, Boise, Idaho. Boyd Baker Rachels, Evans, Georgia. Colin Brenton Rigo, Little Rock, Arkansas. Elizabeth Lee Ritchie, Rome, Georgia. Christopher Adam Robertson, Rome, Georgia. Ella Suzanne Roberts, Rome, Georgia. Antoine Andrew Rocklet McLaughlin, Grand Cayman, Cayman Islands. Molly Tate Sabrin, Rome, Georgia. Lucy Lee Saxton, Cedartown, Georgia. Charles Parker Scott, Rome, Georgia. Joseph Ryland Scott, Rome, Georgia. Catherine Gilstrap Scott, Rome, Georgia. Janet Michelle Scott Crossland, Rome, Georgia. Hamilton Mark Shamblin, Rome, Georgia. Anna Reese Shaw, Rome, Georgia. Charles Carpenter Shaw III, Rome, Georgia. George Edward Shropshire IV, Cartersville, Georgia. Wofford Hill Shropshire, Rome, Georgia. Sophia Kathleen Shoemate, Kingston, Georgia. Grantham Brian Sykes, Rome, Georgia. James Walker Sermons, Rome, Georgia. Bradley Lyon Smith, Rome, Georgia. Phoenix James Smith, Kingston, Georgia. Aisley Emmeline Snell, Brunswick, Maine. Ainsley Allison Tyree Thomas, Atlanta, Georgia. Highland Kaiser Thomas, Rome, Georgia. Elijah Cole Thompson, Calhoun, Georgia. Gwyneth Nicole Traylor, Evansville, Indiana. Lauren Krista Twyman, Rome, Georgia. Yuxuan Wang, Beijing, China. Shun Wang, Hangzhou, China. Caroline Elise Warden, Rome, Georgia. Sarah Michelle White, Spring Hill, Tennessee. Caleb Levi Wohl, Kingston, Jamaica. Jackson Walker Wood, Rome, Georgia. Ji Quin Wu, Hangzhou, China. How Yu Young, Beijing, China. Jialua Zhou, Shenzhen, China. Zixian Zhou, Beijing, China.
If all the graduates would please stand. By the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees, I welcome you into the fellowship of alumni and alumni of Darlington School, with all the privileges and responsibilities attendant thereto. I further charge you to become living examples of the motto of Darlington School, always seeking wisdom more than knowledge, service beyond self, and honor above everything. Alumni of the Darlington Class of 2023, congratulations. Please join me in celebrating this special class. It is my privilege to continue a long-standing Darlington tradition and to leave you with the words of the Apostle Paul. Finally, brethren, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is gracious, if there is in any excellence, if there is in anything worthy of praise, think about these things. What you have learned and received and heard and seen, do, and the God of peace will be with you. Please stand and join the class of 2023 as they sing the alma mater as alumni for the first time, led by Addison Payne.
On the city saw the
Please be seated. Please stand. O God, this graduating class of 2023 now ascends to a broader life and wider experiences. Guide and direct us, we pray, as we advance to new academies of learning and to new pathways of life. Increase in our minds the lessons of the classroom, seal in our hearts the qualities of caring and generosity, and enlarge in our souls the lessons of truth and honor, friendship and loyalty, justice and compassion. Strengthen us in temptation. Inspire and aid us in every good work. Help us to remember that from those to whom much is given, much is expected. Amen.